What's up, people? I'm going to make this short and sweet because I'm getting to the point where, you know, and a lot of people are wondering how come I haven't just lost it in a long time. Self-medication. If you know anything about self-medication, yesterday was the New Year's Eve of self-medication, 420. So hope everybody had an enjoyable 420. I know I did. 420, 520, 620, and 720 because we celebrated it all throughout the all time zones yesterday. A lot of cool things happened. We met somebody who might be able to just give us a taste of what the new website's going to be like. So when we get everything running, because again, now we have a problem because his system doesn't run Mac, so I have to go buy another computer with a different kind of webcam. We're going to be able to stream live. We're going to have a chat room attached to it just to see how it works. And you know what? We'll just sit there all day and see how it works out. But right now, this one's going out to, of course, I appreciate my one, the hater. Now, one thing that pisses me off about all this, you know how I'm just trying to do this? This all started as a goof. Figured I'd show people what it's all about. You know, sympathize with me if you want. Me crying and getting angry about different things. Revolution, barking it out. All the fun times we've had over the last couple of years. But then I get every once in a while, somebody posts something about them losing money using my system. First of all, you know how much I hate that word system. What I provide here is magic, mysticism, something out of the terrestrial realm of understanding. Don't question it. Embrace the horror. Embrace that shit. Okay. So what I was going to say, just when we get that thing going, I'll give you the link. I don't want you to start flooding this guy's website yet. But, okay, so you say you lost 10 grand listening to something I said. Maybe if you were not in the chat room, that could happen to you. Because maybe one day on the show, maybe 9 months ago, I suggested you buy dry ships when I sold out of it at 50. I bet you that there was a moment right after I told you to buy it that you could have made money. I didn't tell you to hang on to it from $50 to $2. Did I? No, of course not. And if you were really paying attention to the show, I don't know how long you joined in, when I covered the short in May, I said, this stock is dead. This stock will be $80 before you know it. Because I just took a beat down. Remember that day I was going to quit the business? I was giving up on everything. I was cashing it in. I couldn't take any more pain. Because I was shorting stocks in May and June and nothing was going down. I couldn't understand why because I knew the market was going to crash any day now. I was just happened to be 3 or 4 months early. I was telling you to short dries, DRYS at 115. I think the exact day was May 15th. So, okay, regardless, you could take anything I say and make it probably, you could interpret it as something I told you to do that was wrong. But I don't tell you, that's why I don't really talk about recommendations here on the show. I tell you to come to the chat room because the magic I possess is pressing these stupid ass buttons. As soon as I let go of the button, boom, stock's going the other way or whatever the hell happens. So what I was suggesting yesterday, if you were in the chat room, I was saying get into the FAZ and get into the SRS because negative triple time ETFs, whatever these things are, they're on the move. And the magic with the SRS, when it broke 30, I don't really trade the SRS, but one of my ETF guys was saying, you have to get into this thing. It's due to go back to 50. Actually, he said 65. So I was like, 65? The stock's trading under 30. So when it broke 30, I gave it a shot. You know me. I buy something at 30. I quickly put an offer out on 30 and a quarter. Boom, I'm done. In the chat room, hey, you guys might want to take a look at the SRS. I sold it at $30.20. It was actually $30.23. Somebody said, all right, time to get in, crawl sold. Immediately, you would have made a point. So I don't know what kind of big player you are out there, but maybe you could have bought 10,000 shares and you would have made your 10 grand back right there in one moment. Oh, but that's just the tip of the iceberg. That's just the tip of the iceberg. We were talking about the FAZ, right? And here's what I don't understand myself, because I'm telling people what to do. But do I do it myself? No. So I was in the FAZ. And I was like, all right, cool. It broke 10. It gapped up over 10. Then it was at 10.50. And I was like, I'm not selling this thing unless it breaks 10. So then there was a moment where it looked like it was going to break 10.50. And suddenly, I thought, oh, you know what? I might as well sell it here to ensure that I to make this profit. And then I told everybody, all right, look, I'm out of the FAZ. at 10:50, you got to get in. So if you just held on to those for the rest of the day, you made money. And I also said at the end of the day, you might want to hang on to them for 3 days because this market sentiment has changed. And you know how the psychology changes just like that in this market. Oh, little bit of fear creeps back in. You gotta get nuts. You gotta start buying triple times ETFs. Oh, Goldman Sachs is going out of business again. You gotta be afraid. Fear ETFs, that's what I call them. Sentiment, fear, and ETFs. You tell me what's inside the FAS and what makes it go in the SRS. And as we're hitting new highs on the SRS, all I know is this guy called me. He's like, you got to understand something. Jefferson, listen to me. The commercial real estate market in New York City is the strongest. And right now, people don't realize that it's not looking too good. It's the last one to take a hit. You got to be buying this SRS. That was my call. And I was like, yeah, what is it? He's like, it's a REIT. It's a real estate triple inverse short ETF. Yeah? I looked at the chart. Thing was like 300 something bucks. It went down to 20. Just looking at just chart wise, it looked like it was going to go up.
Sure, I'll give it a shot. I'll give it a shot.
Next thing you know, the thing's up 5 points. Just open my vein. How about that? All right. So the market's open right now, and I don't care because we gapped down, and now we're rallying, huh? Maybe I should care. All right, let me go care. See you in a bit.